Hello everybody, hello girls and boys, and welcome to another Little Legends. Welcome to our Little Legends. I hope you're all well this week, and I hope you've saved lots of cardboard for maybe making some more in our lovely art and craft class, and maybe some other pieces that you would find around the house, maybe like some old egg boxes or whatever, because you never know when they can come in handy for our art and craft class. Today though, we are concentrating on a lovely little book called BatMouse. And can you see that little mouse? And what are these, boys and girls? These are his lovely little wings, aren't they? And they're kind of held on with, what would you think this is? String? So he's a little bat mouse. Mm-hmm. And he's very high up, isn't he? Because what's this behind him? That's the moon. That's right. Uh-huh. So shall we see what happens to a little bat mouse? It's by Steve Smallman. Squeak! Look, Mum, said Pip. It's a flying mouse. That's not a mouse, says Mum. It's a bat. So there they are, down in the ground, outside their lovely little tree house. Look at the lovely light that's coming from that lovely little tree house. And way up in the sky, somebody has made the squeak, and it's a little bat. The mummy says it's a little bat. I wish I could fly, said Pip. When I grow up, can I be a bat? You can't be a bat, said Mum. Look, you don't have any wings. So Pip made some wings out of cardboard. It was a cardboard box he used. Soon he was ready for takeoff. Can you see him, girls and boys? He looks fantastic, doesn't he? That's the string that we saw at the beginning of the cover, uh-huh. And he's taken some cardboard and he's snip, snip, snip away with the cardboard, and he's made himself some wings and he has used the string to tie them on. He looks a very happy mouse to me, doesn't he? Mm-hmm, he does indeed, boys and girls. He looks a very happy mouse to me. Look, Mum, I'm a bat mouse. Rushed round, squeaking his squeakiest squeak and flapping his cardboard wings up and down. But he just couldn't fly. So he tried again. There he is again, running. And again, running again over this way. And again, running again over that way. So his mum, she's looking on. Do you think she's thinking he's going to fly, boys and girls? Do you think he's going to fly? Call out yes or no whether you think he's going to fly. Oh, right. Mm-hmm. Quite a lot of you think that he is going to. Mm-hmm. Shall we turn the page and find out? Shall we turn the page? So he's flying off this way. Look at how much energy he's putting into that, boys and girls. Can you make that face? And we'll see if his energy works out and he flies. Uh-oh. He flapped till he flopped. Tired and dizzy on the floor. He looks exhausted, boys and girls, doesn't he? Exhausted. Little tongue hanging out. He's really, really tried very hard, I think. Never mind, Pip, said Mum. To cheer him up, she made his favourite supper. Stinky cheese and biscuit crumbs. And look at his little face. I don't know if that's going to make him happy, boys and girls. Stinky cheese. Do you think he likes it? I don't know about that face, boys and girls. Would you like stinky cheese? Can you go, Stinky cheese poo. Can you do that there? Stinky cheese. Stinky cheese poo. Let's see if he eats his stinky cheese supper, boys and girls, and if it makes him feel any better. At bedtime, Pip couldn't get comfortable. His wings kept getting caught in the covers. "That's because bats hang upside down when they sleep," says Mum. She's very clever coming up with all the answers, isn't she? Mm-hmm. So, Pip tried lying upside down, but he still wasn't very comfortable. He doesn't look very comfortable to me, boys and girls. Does he look comfortable to you? Look at him lying upside down. He looks funny, boys and girls, doesn't he? And he's leaning up against his little bed. And then what do we see behind the bed, boys and girls? He's a very clever little mouse. If he's drawn all those pictures, what do you think? I think he's a very clever little mouse. So he has drawn the little frog. Can you see the little frog? Very, very well drawn, I think, boys and girls. Call out if you think that's good. Yes, yes, and give us a clap as well too. Clap, because he's very, very clever little mouse. And also, what's he drawn there, boys and girls? The little bat that maybe he saw, yeah? Will you give him a wee clap again too? Because he's very, very clever, boys and girls. Very clever. And he's still hanging upside down. And he's also very lucky, boys and girls. Look, he's very, very lucky. Those toys that are on the ground, what can you see there? A little ladybird, you're right, And what about here? This is a little mouse. Do you think that's stinky cheese car? Maybe he used the stinky cheese from the supper for a little car? Mm-hmm, maybe so, but he's a very clever little mouse. The next morning, so he's had a good sleep, climbed to the top of Windy Hill. "Time to fly," he squeaked, flapping his wings as hard as he could. Pip jumped. There he is, boys and girls. He's climbed right to the top of the hill with his little cardboard wings strapped on tight. Uh-oh. There he is at the top. Then, bump, he landed on his bottom and rolled over and over and over all the way down the hill. Pip's head was spinning, his bottom was bruised, and his wings were all tattered and torn. Look at them, boys and girls. As he goes down, they're getting more and more tore. Then he heard a familiar sound. Squeak! It was coming from inside a little cave. The cave was dark and spooky. Pip tried to be brave. There he is. Hello? He squeaked. "Hello," said an upside down voice. "I'm Albert. Who are you?" "I'm Pip. And I'm a BatMouse." "Really?" asked Albert. "But you seem to be the wrong way up." "Oops! Sorry," said Pip. And he stood on his head. He stood in his head, boys and girls, to be the same way up as the bat, because look, the little bat is hanging right the way down from the top of the cave. And he was able to see little pup coming up. And Lucky looks a really happy pup now, doesn't he? Because he can see the little bat and he's not afraid of him anymore. Sure, he's not. He still looks a very brave little clever mouse to me. Mm-hmm, he really does. Do you think he looks a very brave, clever mouse? Yeah. Very, very brave and clever. Your wings look a bit cardboardy, said Albert. My real wings haven't grown yet, said Pip. Ah, that explains it, said Albert with a smile. Well, little Batmouse, are you hungry? Pip was very hungry. So boys and girls, look at him lying upside down. And he's trying so hard to be the little bat, isn't he? And he doesn't mind that his little wings are cardboard. He's quite happy because he's made those himself, hasn't he? Mm-hmm. And so I think Albert thinks he's a very clever little bat too, making his own little wings. Have you got any stinky cheese? He asks.
Stinky cheese? Said Albert. Bats don't eat stinky cheese. How about a nice juicy muff?
Look at Pip's face, boys and girls. What do you think he's thinking when he looks at the little fat moth? There's a little fat moth that Albert's holding out, the little bat's holding out to Pip. He's going, oh, can you pull that face, boys and girls? Oh, no, I don't want to eat a moth. I just like stinky cheese. So his little tongue's hanging out, and he is not having any of that, boys and girls. Not by the look on that face. No, he's going, oh, can you go, oh, mm-hmm. Let's see what happens. Pip looked at the moth and burst into tears.
I'm not a Batmouse, he blurted. I don't want to live in a spooky cave, or eat moths, or hang upside down, but I really, really want to fly. Oh, boys and girls, he looks so unhappy, doesn't he? Look at all those little tears running down his face. Can you make a sad face, boys and girls, just like Pip? He's a very sad little mouse. And look at Albert. Look at poor Albert. He doesn't know what to do, boys and girls. He doesn't want to make little Batmouse sad. He's very, very unhappy too.
Then fly with me, said Albert, just this once. He picked Pip up and carried him out into the twinkly twilight sky. So there's the twinkly twilight sky, boys and girls. And we can see the big moon. You see the big moon? Shining bright. It's Pip and Albert, and they soared over Windy Hill, through the treetops, and finally landed right outside Pip's house. Well, little Batmouse, he whispered, do you like flying? I think so, says Pip, who felt dizzy and scared and excited all at once. Thank you, Albert. So boys and girls, he's very excited and he's very scared, but he remembers still to say thank you to Albert because he has just been flying right the way through the sky with its twinkly stars and its big moon. And there he is, and his little face. You can tell by his little face, he's very happy, but he's very sort of scared at the same time, because he's way, way up high above the treetops. But how clever is Albert to bring him right home? Can you see little Pip's house? Way, way in the distance, boys and girls, with the little lights on. How clever is Albert to know where little Pip's house is, to remember that? He's a very, very clever bat as well. As Albert fluttered away, Pip spotted a big pile of earth. First a nose, and then 2 feet, pushed their way above the ground. So there we are, boys and girls. We can see away in the distance, and there is Pip and his mummy outside his house, looking at Albert flying away off into the distance. Can you wave goodbye to Albert for me, boys and girls? Because he was a very, very kind bat to little Pip. Can you wave goodbye to him for me? Wave and say, thank you, Albert. Call, thank you, Albert. Because I think he will hear you, even though because he seems a far, far away, but he's not too far away that he would hear you call. Thank you, Albert. Yeah, I can hear you call him. And then, who do we see here? With his little nose and his 2 little paws up above the earth, he has just dug his way up from the earth, and Pip can see him. Look, he's standing watching him.
Look, Mum, Pip cried. It's a digging mouse.
That's not a mouse, Pip. It's a mole, says Mum, because she knows she's a very clever mummy.
When I grow up, can I be a mole?
Asks Pip. Here we go again, says Mum. And she's standing in the doorway, boys and girls. And look what she's thinking. She's saying, here we go again. And look at little Pip's face. He cannot wait to become a little mole, just like this little chap here. He just wants to be a mole. I wonder what he's going to dress up in to be a mole, boys and girls. Because what did he use again to become a little bat mouse? What did he make it with? That's right, the cardboard and the string. So I wonder what he is going to use now to become a little mole. We'll have to be thinking about that one, won't we? He was a very clever little mouse, wasn't he? And look at the adventure he had with being clever with the cardboard. He had a great adventure. I think he must be. After all that's happened, boys and girls, do you think he's a tired little mouse? I think he's a very tired little mouse too, yeah? I think he'll need to go in and get a lot of sleep now so that he can maybe become a little mole tomorrow. So we wave goodbye to Pip and his mummy and the little mole, and maybe Albert's still away in the distance. So we'll wave bye-bye to them and say thank you for sharing a great adventure with us today, Pip. It was so much fun. Wave goodbye to Pip. That's it, boys and girls. There he is. And so we'll wave bye-bye today, and we'll have another story again soon. In the meantime, don't forget to keep your cardboard and maybe some egg boxes and other little bits and pieces that are around the house, and we'll be maybe making some things like Pip soon. We'll see you again, boys and girls. Bye for now.